So I just got back from the sandblaster with a load of parts. It's real important that you get it all laid out and epoxy primed real quick. It'll flash rust very, very, very quickly just from humidity changes in the shop or whatever. So I got a little bit of work to do these wheels here. A little bit of road rash right there. Oh, and don't touch it. But these are gonna go on my van. So I'm just gonna put one thin coat of epoxy. You can't beat the finish of a sandblasted wheel. Look at all these markings that were just buried under paint. Just look really nice. Got five of these. I'm just gonna set you up and let you watch. All right. I'm gonna have to try hard not to blow the little pieces right off the table. this stuff doesn't spray too incredibly well, but I just put one thin coat on it. It most definitely does a really good job of sealing everything up. I'm gonna let this dry for probably 30 minutes to an hour and come back out here and I'll flip them over and shoot the backsides. I over reduce it when I shoot outside, just kind of seems to flow out a lot better and doesn't dry super fast and doesn't dry spray mainly. It's pretty good. I got a huge stack inside to do as well, so probably at least this many more parts and a few bigger pieces, not as big as wheels, but have to fix a little bit of road rash. These are gonna look good on that van. I've got a good set of center caps and trim rings, the big deep ones, so all the silver you're gonna see is about that much. I haven't decided if I'm gonna base coat, clear coat silver, just use a single stage. But anyways, I'll bring you back when I paint the backside. All right, next batch. Looks good. There's more flash time. I'll bring you back. I forgot to hit the record button when I did the last pass, but stuff's all epoxy primed. Now it's ready for black paint or silver paint or body colored paint or whatever. Nothing beats a sandblasted part that's been properly painted. painted and whatnot. It shows details that you can't get any other way. I've got Mustang parts, Camaro parts, parts for my pickup, the 76. Came out pretty good. So I'm epoxy primer in some more parts this morning. These are Mustang and Firebird parts. These are all used to be stainless trim for the Camaro, the black one, and or chromed. These vent window frames, brand new, chromed, but we're gonna be painting them. I've not painted much trim, so this is gonna be a learning experience for me. So I'm hoping it turns out well, but find out soon enough. This stuff's gonna be a little harder to prime. It's super light. Gonna have to dust it in there a little farther away. These stinking little pieces are blowing all over the place. If this was anything other than shooting the backside of pieces with epoxy primer, I would probably tape them to the paper. Definitely for anything I was actually using paint on, but you can roll some tape up inside out, stick it to the backside of the paper, and then the bottom side of whatever piece you're shooting, and it'll hold it still. But just for shooting a real light coat of epoxy primer, wasn't that worried about them moving around. That ought to get it. This is just an epoxy primer. Its only purpose is to essentially lock the bare metal out so you can't get any moisture or water, anything to cause a rust problem in the underlying metal on top of these panels. They'll get scuffed, and then high build primer, body filler if it needs it, then a lot more high build primer on top of that. This stuff doesn't shoot with the crap. It's like shooting glue, kind of thinned out glue. But only thing here is you just get a good thick coat on it.